Except as the new electoral map that's just out today from NBC News based on current polling. And one big problem you can see here on this map for Donald Trump is that some of the usual toss-up states, some of the states where usually the pollsters say we have no idea who's going to win, states like Colorado, New Hampshire, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, and Virginia, they're no longer considered toss-ups. Those states aren't yellow on this map anymore. After looking at current polling, NBC moved all five of those toss-up states, what are usually toss-up states, moved them all over into the blue column.
Hold it now.
Can I give you a prediction?
Yeah.
It still looks like Hillary's the next president.
You think so?
Yeah, it still looks like that.
Oh, let's keep talking about it all year.
I don't think it's bold at all.
This is not Republicanism as we have known it. These are racist ideas, race-baiting ideas, anti-Muslim, anti-immigrant, anti-women, all key tenets making up the emerging racist ideology known as the alt-right.
What was that? That was Hillary Clinton's speech a few weeks ago denouncing the self-proclaimed alt-right and their support of Donald Trump and Donald Trump's campaign cultivating that support. You remember the speech, you remember the whole discussion around that, but there was this one weird heckling moment in that speech. Here it is again.
All key tenets making up the emerging racist ideology known as the alt-right.
So it's not like an applause moment or like a booing moment or whatever. It's quiet. Everybody's listening to what she says. As soon as she says that phrase, alt-right, some guy yells out from the crowd, Pepe! And to most people, that was a totally inexplicable thing at the moment. It must be totally random. To the white supremacist, anti-Semitic, neo-Nazi right in this country, that guy yelling that out in that moment, that was a moment of triumph. That was the most hilarious thing they had ever heard in their lives. Because Pepe refers to Pepe the Frog, this otherwise innocuous cartoon character, which, as unlikely as it may sound, it is one of the things that the racist right has adopted as a symbol online. South Carolina and Kansas, you would think those would be not just likely, but likely slash slam dunk slash guaranteed slash obviously this is ruby red, South Carolina and Kansas. But instead, they're light red. They're just lean Republican now. South Carolina leans Republican?
The state of South Carolina has gone Republican.
Kansas leans Republican?
Donald Trump, we project, will win. Kansas, with its six electoral votes.
And if those are the toss-up states, if you do the math associated with all the electoral votes from all of the states, if they go that way, if the lean Republican and likely Republican go red, and the lean Democrat and likely Democrat go blue, if you sign those out that way, and then you say that Donald Trump has the best day in the entire world, completely outperforms expectations, and he wins all of the toss-up states. He wins all five of those states, plus that electoral college vote in Maine that he's after. If he wins all of the toss-ups, which would be insane because nobody wins all of the toss-up states, even if Donald Trump did win all of the toss-up states, he would still lose. Hot off the presses, we are breaking this news right here, right now. You're gonna think I'm kidding. But the presidential race appears to be tied in South Carolina. Yes, I said South Carolina, not North Carolina.
Right now, the state of South Carolina has gone Republican.
And this is a Democratic polling firm, but this is a real polling firm. This is legit methodology. And they are finding a tie in presidential politics in South Carolina?
What if we're seeing something else, something deeper, a more permanent separation between Clinton and Trump? Could we be seeing our first true landslide in a long time? A double-digit landslide. That is Clinton's lead in four polls now. And the last time an election ended with a candidate winning by double digits, well, you got to go all the way back to this.
We're watching a really phenomenal development tonight as Ronald Reagan continues to roll through the country. So far, Walter Fritz Mondale has won only the District of Columbia. All those states that you see behind me that are colored blue are the states that we have projected Ronald Reagan the winner in tonight.
Because people think the disease is so acute, they're willing to take the strongest medicine possible. I think that's what we are seeing. The cancer was Washington, and a lot more people than we predicted, than our pollsters predicted.
But then why aren't any incumbents losing?
Well, you know, George W. Bush campaigned for, I think, every Republican who won tonight on the board. And his message was anti-protectionism, anti-isolationism, and anti-nativism. So voters are really smart, and I think they've calculated that at the top they want change.
But it can't be that Washington's...
But how is that smart if you're voting for two different things, right?
I'm return all of Congress.
You're voting for two
diamonds
and close
things. Then why isn't she winning? And listen, it is far more likely at this point he wins than she wins. It is far more likely at this point that, you know, and I say this not as someone who voted for him, but it is far more likely that he wins, and it is far more likely that tomorrow morning we're talking about a Trump cabinet than a Clinton cabinet.
That's, I'm not disputing that. What I'm disputing is that the diagnosis is that people wanted to get rid of Washington. Because if they wanted to get rid of Washington, they would have thrown out Ron Johnson.
She's been there 30 years. I think at the top, they viewed her as less appealing than him. I'm looking at the same polls
you are. It's not a diagnosis for the rest of what happened tonight. I think is a fascinating thing. I don't know what it means that the Republican Party survives intact, and the only thing that changes is a radically different type of person at the top.
I am not saying it's intact. I am not saying it's intact.
What changes?
Paul Ryan and Jim Comey, two Republicans, become like the last dinosaurs tomorrow morning.
And there is how so many Hillary Clinton supporters are reacting in that room.
It's an interesting decision by the campaign to come out and say, go home, we're not going to say anything else tonight. I mean, it's true that there are five races that are either too close or too early to call.
For Donald Trump this evening, 228-209.
Am I correct that we're going to hear from John Podesta soon from the podium?
Well, here's what we know, Brian. He is headed over here. What's significant about that is that the Clinton campaign has largely gone dark for well over an hour now. A number of people have left in tears. There is stunned disbelief as these results, as they come in. Earlier in the evening, they were looking for any sign that there was a potential path forward. When the results of Nevada, for example, came in, the crowd burst into cheers. But now, really, it's just silence as they listen to the music playing and await to hear what happens next.
Have now confirmed that Secretary Clinton has conceded to Donald Trump. This concession took place in a phone call, we anticipate just moments ago. And as we are awaiting Donald Trump taking the stage here, that is the news at this hour. Secretary Clinton has conceded to Donald Trump.
You're awake, by the way. You're not having a terrible, terrible dream. Also, you're not dead and you haven't gone to hell. This is your life now. This is our election now. This is us. This is our country. It's real.
Left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. Restless dreams, I walked alone. Narrow streets of cobblestone. Neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light, split the night. catch the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking. People hearing without
this man might be the president is racist, homophobic, transphobic, sex offender might be the president.
It has to be a joke. I do not believe this is happening. I'm literally about to fucking kill myself, and I'm not kidding. You better fucking fix this shit right now. I literally am gonna die. I need an ambulance. I can't.
Oh no. Oh my god. Ezra's going, oh shit.
Oh my god.
I just knew it. Donald Trump has been mentioned. How you feel right now?
So let me say, and to state privilege,
Donald J. Trump is now President of the United States.
What a great honor to be able to introduce for the first time ever anywhere the 45th President of the United States of America, Donald.
And further, to adjust the microphone as it's all, man.
And for their gracious aid throughout
this. I am so sorry! To my world, I am so sorry to my world. This is not what we want.
We will face
challenges.
There's
so much potential.
But we will get the job done.
For beauty and for devastation.
Every 4 years we gather.
In this one moment, it's almost incomprehensible that they can exist right now. So
and we are grateful.
So close.